I'm Gözde, the co-founder and CEO of Vivo. Vivo is a wellness assistant that provides personalized nutrition and lifestyle advice based on your urine. If you look at the problem in the market, if you look at the problem in the market, we all want to know about our bodies. We all want to know our needs. But that's why we use some trackers, some health apps. But if we use them, we learn that just how many steps we have taken or how many liters of water we drank. But all apps or all trackers are giving us a generic guidance. But wellness is a personal journey, and that's why we created Vivo. This is a urine trip. You urinate on these small boxes, and then you take a photo via our app, and then get your personalized advice. What can we detect? If you have any infection, and if there is in your kidney or liver, or how many water you will consume, or do you have any blood or sugar or glucose in your urine? And we have advice such as you have a mild infection in your body, and that's why you should consume cranberries. And this is our market. It's over than $57 million, and it's a huge. We know, and we have so many competitors, but we are the first step to ask your urine. This is our differentiation, and we have a Vivo box, and we have a subscription model, and you subscribe us and get a Vivo box, and it contains 4 strips, and it's just a $14 for USA, and also we have a corporate wellness guidance for B2B market. And what have we done until today? We had an investment from 500 startups, and with that we completed our product. And now we will launch our product with Kickstarter in June. And now we are seeking for investment for that and for marketing. And this is our team. We are 8 people, including dietitians, designers, bioengineers, and developers. And we have had some doctors in our advisory board, and we all developed an easy-to-use tool for your body needs, for learning your body to be your body voice, and it's Vivo. Thank you.
Tell me, why would a consumer want to subscribe? I mean, you do it once, maybe every 6 months, once. I mean, why would I want to have a recurring test?
Okay,
for my whatever.
It's a really good question. Because we all want to track our body's needs. My body needs is changing in every week, in every day. If you drink so much alcohol today, and my liver is not working as good as yesterday's, and that's we want to monitor ourselves. That's
somebody that has already a health issue. You mean?
Yes, of course, because
who needs to monitor, but it's not.
Yes, we use trackers or we use health apps for that.
So the your market is for your consumer is somebody who already has a health issue, not somebody who wants to know if there is something wrong, right?
In fact, that's both of them are consumers.
Model. Excuse me?
In fact, both of them are consumers. I am a healthy person and I just want to monitor myself or my family has a diabetes, and I have to check my sugar level, in fact, my glucose level in my urine. And so I have to use Vivo, or I'm a health person, I will use Vivo.
Do you have users already? We will
open beta level in end of this month, but now we developed our product with 15 consumers, and most of them female.
Your first target market is the United States, is that right?
Yes.
So talk about the regulatory stuff that you trip into. They must be all over you, or are you a medical device? What are you from the regulatory perspective?
In fact, my co-founder is in USA, and I'm in Turkey, because our team and manufacturing is in Turkey.
I'm asking you about regulation, because you know, every 23andMe, okay, everyone has been ripped apart by our regulation. So do you have any issues at all?
This is my best question. We talked to FDA before, and they just said that our app is so low risk, so it's not a medical device. So we just registered our strips. We will apply end of this month, in fact, for FDA and CE.
So no FDA clearance?
Yes, just register our strips, because we changed the design of the urine strips.
Your prime prospect looks like to be someone who's very affluent, techie, and capable of using this. So Which is this a very niche market, in your opinion, or is it a mass market?
In fact, Vans market is more than $4,000 billion and $4,000 USD, and mobile health market is more than $57 million. It's a really huge market, and in fact, all technology is going to home diagnostic, but we have no ready for the home diagnostic. That's why we created Vivo. In fact, we had a diagnostic company before, and we learned that people has not ready for the advice. Told me you might have a cancer, go to the doctor. Because for that we have to prepare the market for people's home diagnostic tools.
How will you convince people to use the product, because it's just not something that most people like to do?
I have never solved the problem, because when I told my product to people, they all want to use it, in fact. And after FDA, we have a clearance, and that's it's said more trustable for people. It can be.
How will you get your, how will you do your customer acquisition? Do you know already?
We will never sell it, in fact, so we just a customer acquisition cost for subscription. Now we are just an online advertisement in Facebook or Google.
So you're going to need a lot of money.
For marketing, yes, we are thinking for $4,000, $400, $400,000.
To scale your business in the United States, I mean, this is a massive, massive market that requires...
Yes, of course.
More than $4,000.
Help me. Thank you.
Okay, I will.
Excellent. Nice job.
Okay, thank you.
Very good job. Oh.